Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy. Welcome back to more Xenoblade Chronicles. Last time, we returned to Colony 6, contributed to the reconstruction efforts. We then came up to Aerith Sea once more, where we found the ether plant here. We kicked off a chain of quests that resulted in Melia getting her fourth skill tree. Love that view of the Makanas in the distance, but that's not what we're here to do. As much as I wish that we could just make 30-minute videos of me gawking at the scenery, let's not do that. Instead, this time, we're still going to be primarily doing side quests. These ones aren't quite as important or give you quite as cool rewards as what we have been doing, but I still feel that this one is one that I want to take out here nonetheless. Yes, there's only one chain of side quests that I really want to knock out, and you know how it's supposed to be a secret that Melia's traveling with us and they have that decoy Melia in the capital? Well, we're going to say screw all that and just waltz right into Alchemoth where anybody could see her traveling with us. Presumably while that other Melia with the mask is getting seen by other residents at the same time. Now, in this area, not who I want to talk to actually, I need to switch the clock to daytime. As much as I liked that sunset and I wanted to open the video on that, we needed to be proper daytime for this. Okay. So, we have these two guys right here. We need to talk to Karolf, and our head is obstructing his quite nicely. Me and my partner decided where we're adventuring next. We know there's a chance we might not make it back unharmed. But that's what makes it such a thrill, right? I guess I get what you mean. After talking to him, Zane will have a quest for you. And actually, I want to switch around the party a little bit because Melia is not the one who comments on this. Instead, it is the legendary Hereupon. Then again, the real question is, why is Ricky not always in the lead? He is the main character, after all. We're not even close to being ready to set off there. What should we do? Ooh, sound like something wrong. Tell Ricky, tell Ricky. What is the matter? You may tell us your problem. I see this as she's like patting down Ricky, telling him to cool it because they're kind of sensitive. Yes, we'd like to help you. Well, I'm grateful. You see, I'm an adventurer. But this time, the place I want to go to is really quite harsh. I'm really stressing out about getting drinking water there. But apparently, water from certain waterfalls has a special property. No matter how cold it gets, it never freezes. Ah, heading off to a cold region. Well, what a coinkydink, so are we. Waterfall? Why no water freeze? Water is water, yes? That weird. Suppose it could be mineral water. Yeah. Truth is, I don't know either. But it doesn't freeze, so I'm not complaining. Well, apart from about the fact that I don't know what to do about it. We have multiple quest objectives, but we will get Strength up 3, Ether up 3, and Agility up 3. All really important stats, and this is not a difficult quest whatsoever. If those gems sound good to you, you probably want to do this. So we will go and find him some water. Karolf, my partner, is really going to be happy too. Easy peasy, Hereupon take care of it, lemon squeezy. Dunban's gonna help as well, so we should have absolutely no problem. So, the areas that we need to go, the reason why the High Entia can't do this is they're supposed to still be unknown to the people of Bionis, at least until Kallion comes down to talk to them and say how they've been ignoring their problems all this time. So, because they don't want to reveal themselves quite yet, we have to go back all the way to Bionis Leg, because right here at Believer's Paradise, if you've discovered it, is a really convenient location because it is right on top of where we need to go to collect this waterfall water because, I'm saying because a lot, wow. Well, anyway, Kasharpa Falls is right here, and that is what is important. Wow, there's quite a few nebula here as well. What's up with this heart-to-heart? I don't think we've seen this one yet, can we? No, I definitely can't view that one yet. It's odd, because I usually use Shulk and Dunman a lot, and they usually have pretty high affinity by this point. Anyway, this height is, like, multiplied by 10 because Ricky's the one jumping off of it, and... Oh! Whoa! I thought I was gonna hit the ground there for a second. Anyway, to Kasharpa Falls we go. We actually never discovered Kasharpa Falls as a location, so I was kind of talking from experience when I said that I don't usually like to do that. It's odd, I swore that I walked into this area and discovered it before, but I guess not. I'll take my 22 experience and enjoy it because it's such a drop in the bucket compared to what I'm getting. And speaking of drops in the bucket, how about we take this drop of this waterfall water and stick it in our bucket? We got Kasharpa water. Second, we need to go to the Divine Sanctuary near Great Makna Falls, because, believe it or not, that is indeed the second waterfall that we need to go to, and, see how far away that looks? It's actually even further than it looks, believe it or not. We need to swim all the way to the west side of that. That is going to take quite a while, and I'm gonna believe that you don't really want to see that, so, this water actually has a current to it, and swimming against it does take longer than swimming with it. One time that I kind of wish things weren't so realistic. And wow, Great Makna Falls landmark, okay. Doesn't matter what angle, what weather, what time of day, or anything that you're viewing the Great Makna Falls at, it's always majestic and always breathtaking, and that wavy rainbow is cool. Is there really such a thing in our universe? Because I would be very surprised if there actually was. Anyway, though. Among all of these gigantic falls, there is one tiny little red item orb, and we are swimming up to it. You see that over there, like in the fog? Yeah, that's where we need to go. I'm gonna show the map after this just to kind of give you a better idea of exactly where I am if you're having trouble finding this, because this is a really big body of water, and I really would not want to. Wow, this is starting to look really muddy. Can we just collect it, please? There we go, good. The exact location of this item orb is right here. See how big this body of water is? Yeah. Have fun! And the last place we needed to go is the Sororal Statues in Satoral Marsh. I will say, for being such a gorgeous area that was all over the marketing and just so many other things, you sure don't go back to this area that often. Like, we haven't really revisited Satoral Marsh since our initial visit there, at least I don't think we have. And this is just some random little quest that you could very easily skip over. For an area that I like spending so much time in, there really isn't as much to do here as other areas, so it's kind of strange, to be honest. I'm not really sure why that is. I mean, who doesn't just want to be standing in this area for all eternity, staring up into the sky and all the trees shimmering? It's just, it's all so good. Then again, I guess that is kind of stagnating, and that is kind of bad. Even though we got what we came for, I don't want to take off quite yet. If you look at the map, there's a heart-to-heart location over to the west of the Nopon Merchant Camp. I want to head there because we can actually view this heart-to-heart, and we don't really get to come to Satoral Marsh that often, so I think this would just be a good time to knock that out. Oh my god, this view is breathtaking! We have the Shimmering Marsh. And what is it with these Shulk and Dunben heart-to-hearts that we're seeing today? This place is beautiful. Some call it the Shimmering Marsh. I can see why. Had you ever been here before? No, and I'm suitably amazed. How can a place light up so much at night? I've never seen anything like it. I have, once when I was very young. Really? Interesting. It was at the ruins where me and the Minato were found. Same thing happens there, at night. Glowing ether fills the air. So that's where you saw it. I don't remember much about the ruins. I found my way in, and then I lost consciousness. That's about all I can remember back then, except the light. If it was as beautiful as this, no wonder you remember it. Ether is an incredible thing. It really is. Will it ever run out? Great question, Dunban. I've always wondered that. Great minds think alike, and your thoughts? I can't draw any firm conclusions or anything. All I know is ether isn't unlimited, so I guess it won't last forever. I don't suppose we have anything to worry about in our lifetime. Maybe not, but we should still try and find another energy source. We can't just rely on it always being there. Energy aside, it will be a shame when this natural beauty is gone. Yes, whether that's 100 years from now or 1,000. That is one of my favorite heart-to-hearts. I just find it, well, for lack of a better word, heartwarming. Even though I've described other heart-to-hearts with that location. With that word before, it's just, there is no better word, and that is why the achievement for doing really well on them is heartwarming, let's face it. As per usual, at the end of the video, I'll be showing the other paths that you can go down with that, but for now, let's just return to the Fountain of Eternity and turn in these items. Hello there again, Zane. Yes, I am there. Yes, are you there? I guess I really owe you a lot. Water was the only real sticking point on this expedition, but now we're all set. Yay, yay, happy! Ricky, really happy! How adorable. We owe everything to you lot. You really saved us. I'll never forget this. Oh wait, I almost forgot. Here you go. Yeah, you better not forget our rewards. Those are some really awesome rewards right there. Thanks, man, for all those cool gems. Take them all. But we are not quite done here. And because we're not done here, who better to get it done than Dunban? Haha, Kuralf has a quest for us. Curses! Where did I drop it? At this rate, all my hard work's gonna go to waste. Hmm? You seem troubled. Hereupon we'll solve all problems! Oh, you're the guys that Zane was talking about. You just saw us in front of your face! How could you not know that we helped you? You were right within earshot! So, okay, what's your problem? Have you guys seen a white spherical storage thing around? You haven't? Oh man, what am I gonna do? Looks like you're in trouble. Lost something? Yeah, something real important. I'm going on another adventure with Zane, yeah? And there's a really important cream we need for the journey. But guess what? I dropped it somewhere. What do you need cream for? Well, I guess an ointment. Need a cream for an adventure with Zane, you say? And I needed to use it somewhere cold. Had it while mining for crystals with Zane. I bet you did. We need to find the chalk container on Anu's shore in Aerith Sea. We've never been to Anu's shore. This quest also has some pretty good rewards between Muscle Up 3 and Aether Defense Up 3. So we'll get some nice rewards for this as well. But where exactly is Anu's shore? Well, if you look at the map for Aerith Sea, they said they were mining for Aether crystals. There is a mining location to the north of the High Entia tomb that we have never discovered. So, yeah, this is gonna be the beginning of us. Well, not really the beginning, because I think we've done it once already, but we gotta swim through a dang ocean. This is gonna be something, alright. There's a cave entrance over there that we wanna aim for, and while it doesn't look all that far like the Great Makna Falls, it's farther than it looks because of just how gigantic it is. It's kinda like mountains in real life. But at least we get this breathtaking view of all the hovering ramps when we go there. Yay. At long last, we've arrived at Anu's shore, and of course there is an ether mining area in this area. I'm just speaking really redundantly today, I don't know what it is, but... there it is, there's the red item orb that we need to collect. This will get us... the chalk container, interesting. But that's not all that's here. First off, I want to switch over to Shulk for this, because trust me, you don't want to do this with anyone other than Shulk. It turns out that Anu's shore is the location of one of the unique monsters that we needed to hunt for a challenge quest. Remember how I didn't quite hunt everything that we needed to take care of last time because we'd be going to these areas eventually? Well, this is the eventually! Lightspeed Sonnet, level 44 unique monster, and to top it off, it's got really mean spike attacks. You really want some way of dealing with those, either Gems, or Melia, or Shulk. 400 damage with one attack countered right there, it's crazy! Dunban, draw the aggro, please. Thank you. I was about to say- Oh! No! You have your back to a cliff! I can't backslash you like that! Alright, well, this is probably gonna take a little while, and that's really all I had to say about this enemy, so, see you guys in just a moment. Oh boy! If my health is any indication, that was not an easy battle, and, at least it got a voice crack out of me, so I can tell you guys are gonna like it. Oh, my dignity. Anyway, let's mine these ether crystals and let's get the heck out of here and never come back, because I don't think there's anything else to this area. Only thing to be cautious of, you definitely don't want to lose that fight, because there is a- Oh! I did not know there were level 80 monsters here. Apparently the unique monster we needed to hunt here was like the weakest of the bunch, which begs the question why that quest giver wanted us to kill that thing and not the others. Hello again, Kuralth. You actually have a really cool character design, didn't ever realize that. We indeed found out where was it near the crystals? So I dropped it when I was mining them. I feel bad for making you run around like that. Well, not so much running as swimming, but still. If I did that, then I could have saved you a lot of bother. Well, at least we get the gems regardless, so I'm not too cut up over it, even though we did almost die to an axe. Thanks to you guys, Zane's not gonna have a go at me. Thanks for everything. With that, we have completed Preparing for Adventure 2! Sounds like some kind of really cool movie title or something like that. We get those, and... of course, we are not done yet. Alright, Zane, tell Ryan what's on your mind. Got any emergency rations? We need them right away. I'm all ears! Ryan, are you sure we have time to get involved in this? Ryan, are you sure we have time to get involved in this? We'll have it finished in no time! Oh god, they knew it, they knew it. We're not gonna be able to make it there and back in just a few days. That's why we need rations that'll keep us for a fair while. From what I've learned, Orthless Liver works best for rations. You can get it from Lakebed Orthrus near Colony 9. I can't make it down there, so could you get it for me, please? So let me get this straight. You want us to walk all the way down the Bionis, kill something, rip its liver out, and then walk all the way back up? Wouldn't it, like, spoil in that time besides? Why are you asking us to deliver it for you if that's the situation? I apologize. In all seriousness though, we have Preparing for Adventure 3! Hey, describes the Sonic fandom for the past 12 years! I couldn't resist. Anyway, this isn't Colony 9, but it's at Agora Shore. So for the third time, we have to go to Agora Shore, even though there is no skip travel point there and it's so far out of the way. Seriously, would it have killed them to put a skip travel point on Agora Shore? For how many things you have to go there for, it's just... You have to swim there so many times in the process of getting 100%. Nobody wants to do that. Also, what in the name of His Highness Kalion is it with you guys and making us swim places for you? Seriously, every one of these quests has involved swimming in some way. What is up with this? So now that we've arrived at Agora Shore, and I don't need to play as Shulk to be able to reliably fight this monster, I would like to play as Ricky because he's actually learned a few new arts. Now, forgive me if I've gone over these already in a past video. I don't think that I have, but it's just been so long since my last one, and I have tried watching my past few videos just to make sure there's no overlap, but it is possible that I might have missed some things. First off, he's got Sneaky, which is basically a backslash. It's times 3 damage if you use from behind. Unfortunately for me, this enemy is near water, so getting behind him is not the easiest thing in the world. His other attack, and I swear I've gone over this, but I couldn't really find any time that I did, plus I know exactly what joke I would have made if I had gone over this, and I certainly have not made this joke yet. He's got Freezinate, which inflicts chill, which we've seen before, but he has Burninating the Countryside, Burninating the Peasants. Yeah, he has Burninate. Burninate does more damage, and it attacks all enemies. It's Aether attribute, just like Freezinate is. Now the question is, if it does more damage and it hits everything, why would you ever want Freezinate in the first place? Doesn't Freezinate just seem, you know, redundant and unnecessary when Burninate is a thing? Well, no. Thing is, there are times when you don't want to get the attention of other enemies, and Burninate has a really, really big attack radius. Because of this, you could unintentionally get the attention of a monster that you really, really just do not want to bother with. So, whenever you want to be careful, it's kind of better to have Freezinate even though it does less damage. Either way, we got a chain attack here. How about we try this? Let's go for a Sneaky! Ricky Sneaky! Rhine time! Boom! Ooh, damn, a sword drive into that. 12,000 damage. Melia, why do you not have an element on you? This is what I mean by your AI sucking, because all it does is just spam elementals. Ugh. I don't really think there's anything else that I want to say about this. Rhine! Rhine currently has HP down status. That's not something that you see in RPGs typically. HP down makes it so that your max HP gets cut in half, and when it wears off, you're gonna have whatever your max HP was before, assuming that you have full health. It's just, it is a really, really big way to kill the way that Rhine deals with enemies. Sponge tanking, I've already said, is not nearly as good as agility tanking, and this kind of furthers that whenever you have enemies that have that status. Dunban, on the other hand, wouldn't really be losing too much of his health because he doesn't have a whole lot of HP. There we go! The elemental discharge I wanted in the first place. And ooh, another attack! We're behind him. We got Bitey Bitey. Let's make his butt bleed! Not quite. Come on, Rhine. Do me proud. Times 5, attack combo! Oh, come on! And there we go. That is the Orthril's liver. Was it carrying, like, soup or something like that? I swore I saw something like that. If so, that is actually kind of morbid. Let's take the liver. Hello there, Zane. Yes, we have the liver. I'm really in your debt. Now we're ready to adventure.
Ready for adventure!
Sorry, I can't help it. It just slips out sometimes. Karalth and me are looking forward to this adventure. When we get back, we'll tell you all about it. Well, that's that. Yes, a satisfactory performance. This is thanks from both of us. You did an amazing job. We get the Mithril Gear, Mithril Gauntlets, and Mithril Boots, and they are all done preparing for Adventure 3. Sonic fans, do you wish you could be these guys? Because I sure do. We get all of our items, and there we are. Yet, strangely, they haven't really gone anywhere yet. Let's talk to them once more. Really owe you one for helping me out back there. If I hadn't found it, Zane might have disowned me as his partner. That's just how important that stuff was. Can't believe I lost it. What about you, Zane? Anything of note to say? One of my acquaintances really loves stargazing. She really loves listening to stories about my adventures. You've no idea how it makes me feel. Well, who is that? Come on, tell us. I want to talk to this person. Well, no matter how much you talk to him, he's not going to say anything about that. So, it's kind of up to you to figure out that... That the person they're talking about is indeed out at nighttime, hence the stargazing, and they are this person, Muriel. I'm sorry to bother you, but please listen. This is urgent. Zane and his friends haven't come back from their adventure. They were just here like 10 seconds ago. That's a bit of a pain. That a big problem. This is terrible. Both their lives are in danger. And last I heard, they said they were going to Valak Mountain, making preparations to see some ruins or something like that. But they haven't come back. Please, please go and rescue them. Valak Mountain is a death trap to think they actually went. Reckless and foolish. How did they get sanctioned to go there in the first place? I don't care about any sanction. They've gone and it's too late. Aren't their lives more important? Yes, you are correct. Come, we must make haste if we were to save Zane and Karelth. The two of them are on Valak Mountain, which is where we're heading to next in our adventure anyway, so when we go to Valak Mountain, we'll have to keep an eye out for the two of them. This is kind of why I wanted to grab this one before we headed off, but believe it or not, I am actually still not done with all the things that I wanted to take care of beforehand, because there are a few things I want to do in, believe it or not, Makna Forest. I kind of wanted to save the quest in this area for last because it's the path to Valak Mountain, so that's my reasoning there. There's not a whole lot that I want to do here, but we will be spending a little bit of time in this area. The Snop-on merchant that gave us his monster quest when we first arrived, remember him? Yeah, old no-name, that's him. He wants us to kill Shimmering Forte at X Watering Hole. So he's got a new quest for us, a challenge quest to be precise. And what's really strange is that he will not have this quest for you for a while. I have seen a lot of conflicting evidence on this. Some sources claim that you have to visit Frontier Village once, some claim that you have to beat the Telethia here, some claim that you gotta finish up at Prison Island, and that's when it opened up for me, so we're just gonna go with that. Twisted Tree Gate. Now, it only appears on warm days, as he was saying, and you can't really convey temperature in terms of visuals, unless it's cold. Never mind, you totally can, like am I saying. It's a little bit strange to tell the two apart, so... Oh, actually... No, for a second there, I thought that was it. It indeed looks like an Infernal Dinus. I know, around the X watering hole, you'd expect it to look like one of the Makna X, but of course not. I personally suggest switching the time to 3 p.m. because I generally have the best luck with making it, warm weather with that. But that's just me. Now, this is what a normal day looks like. That's not a warm day. Oh, whoa, it spawned right on top of me. Okay, not a smart place to stand, but as you can see, it's only level 33. Something tells me you were intended to fight this on your first visit to Makna Forest, because by the time this can even appear, it's laughably weak compared to you. I mean, I'm not complaining. I get a free affinity coin after hunting a unique monster, but still, I kind of would have liked a little bit stronger of an enemy to deal with. I mean, not even me being overleveled, it's flat out that it just does not, this quest is not available for a while, and there's no point in killing it before then. Plus, on top of that, it spawns on this really rare weather, which, by the way, you can see what it looks like on a foggy day, it just looks a little blurrier. It doesn't really look different at all. But we got 25,000 gold for that, I shouldn't really complain, a gold chest drop from it. And we get, Serpent Biter, that actually sounds really cool. With that dead, though, I want to go onward a little bit, because right around here is something really interesting that I have not done yet. You could have technically done this on your first visit to Makna Forest, of course, because, as we know, Xenoblade is really big, open, non-linear, and, well, gigantic, putting it quite frankly. I personally didn't do this, and I don't think there's any quests at all that tell you about this, so hopefully I'm not wrong about that, because if the next quest that I do tells me to go here, you guys are going to get really mad at me. Well, okay, I don't think you'll get mad at me, because this is still something really awesome nonetheless. I want to switch the clock over to nighttime, why you'll see in a little bit. There's the southern path that is going out of the X watering hole, and we've never been down this before, so I want to fill in my map a little bit more. There is indeed a heart-to-heart icon down there, but that is not the piece de resistance. There's a shoral mushroom here, which isn't really it either. You can jump up this way and get this item orb, and things are looking awfully shimmery behind tree trunk. Let's just see what it is around the bend. Secret area, sparkling pool, and we get a level up for Shulk. It is so beautiful. It's just all shimmery and these waterfalls. It's like one of those artificial chlorine pools with like lighting in it, yet it just occurs naturally. It's so gorgeous. I love it. I wish this kind of place was near me. All right, well, there is a heart-to-heart right here. And you know what? We're doing a second one within the same video. Yeah, this is gonna be a long end slate day. We have no boys allowed. Okay, that was kind of piggish, I have to admit. But when you hear a title like that, how can you resist? What a beautiful spring. Makes me want to jump right in. It does look inviting. It would certainly cool us down. Are you alright, Melia? It looks as if the heat's getting to you. You may be correct. Maybe you should take a rest. That may be in order, I believe. I am starting to see things. That doesn't sound good. Maybe the forest air doesn't agree with you. It's very humid here. Don't worry, I just need a minute to compose myself. Well, if you say so. Oh, I've got a great idea. Let's take a dip, just you and me. It'll cool us both down, and it might even make you feel better. Are you sure? Sure, I'm sure. We won't get another chance like this, and the water's crystal clear. But I, well... Didn't you used to go swimming outdoors when you were a kid? No, never. Father would not have allowed something like that. Then why not make up for lost time? It's the perfect chance. You are right. Let's go swimming, Sharla. I hope Shulk doesn't see me. It's so sad with the cutscenes lately of Melia asking about Fiora and all these other things and this, that, and the other. It's just... I don't even know what to think anymore, but Sharla is right. Not being able to have fun times as a kid, you make up for it in your adulthood. That's what I live my life on. I think that about does it for now, though. Next time on Xenoblade Chronicles, we are going to be returning to Frontier Village very briefly, checking out just one little tiny thing, and then heading off to Valak Mountain. See you guys then. Thank you.
Thank you.